Hi everyone, this is Brendan here. Welcome to my next episode, Day 28 of my Let's Clash series. So let's start the episode by watching this defensive replay on my base on this premature Town Hall 8. And this guy is definitely going to 3-star it using some Giants and some Archers, which both of them they are level 4, and using his Barbarian King, which is level 5, and some Wall Breakers, which are also level 4, and just continuing to rampage through the base. Giants just tanking up and soaking up the damage for the archers behind. The archers just shoot the thing over the wall. And also in the rage spell, they do quite a huge amount of damage, especially when they walk really fast and sometimes the mortar even miss hitting them. So that's the good thing about using rage spell, where your troops walk really fast and the mortar sometimes they do miss your troops. Even sometimes the wizard towers, they do miss some shots on your troops that are running really quickly. Especially for those troops that are already running that really quickly, such as the goblins or even minions, sometimes they do miss their hits on those kind of troops. But yeah, even archers can be missed by using some rage spell. So yeah, going ahead with my very own attack, of course, trying to get back and recuperate the loss that I suffered with the 300 over 1000 gold that I suffered just now from the defensive attack. So going ahead with my very own on this base with 200 over 1000 gold available, and definitely going to go for the gold and try to get a 50% 1 star so that I do not lose the raid, because it's quite an easy base to attack and definitely go for the 1 star. So dropping my clan castle on the top over there with the wizards coming out now, taking a few hits on the structures and then they go down really quickly. So the wizards, they are still really my best CC combination right now. I might tweak it a little bit when I reach to maybe 25 slots available, maybe adding like a few more archers or whatsoever. Some of you guys have suggested to me to use like one giant and the rest will be wizards. I was considering that, but then I thought to myself, why must I have the giant? I mean, I would use the barbarians to tank for my wizards, unless I'm just gonna drop my clan castle at one spot whereby I didn't have enough barbarians with me. Yeah, but I might consider using that, having a one level 7 giant in my clan castle together with 5 other wizards when I reach to 25 housing spaces for my clan castle. So now going ahead to do more raids, trying to get my goal up to increase and definitely farm for the walls. So my walls, they are already all to level 7. So I'm trying to get all of them to level 8, which is going to take some time and a lot of goal farming. So definitely I have to go ahead and take the time to focus on the goal. Not too much on the elixir right now, because the walls, they kind of be upgraded with the elixir. So going ahead with the raid, I was trying to 3-star this Tower 7 to be honest, as I was quite confident to 3-star this base, but then my troops didn't go in the exact way that I wanted them to go, especially the wizards. They broke through the wall on the top there and they took out the mortar. That was good, but then they didn't follow through to carry on with my troops on the right side. They got taken out by the cannon and also the wizards tower on the left side. So eventually I didn't have enough wizards to try to take out the whole entire base, but I managed to take out the town hall right now. So town hall is gonna go down now, and I managed to take all the gold also. So just left with 37,000 gold available. The troops just gonna continue to clear up the base with that last gold mine gonna go down right now. And now the wizard tower is gonna take out a lot of my archers. So there's not really a point to continue to try to 3-star the base, because the wizard tower is just too strong for my archers without any barbarians to tank the damage off from the archers. And now going ahead with the next attack on this Town Hall 9 with a lot of the gold being outside, especially when they're all inside the gold mine. So attacking from the right first, then after that the top there was actually one gold mine over there. The left side, there were actually 3 gold mines and one on the bottom. So I was focusing my troops on the left side, and then once the troops have already gone through and taken out that archer tower, I went to deploy my troops at the bottom to try to take out the Barbarian King first. And then my whole group of archers came around to take out the Barbarian King together with the gold mine at the bottom. So I managed to take out all 6 gold mines. So usually what I do is I will count and locate where the locations of the gold mines are, and then I'll try to focus my troops at that particular spots. So usually for Town Hall 9s, there are only 6 gold mines available on the whole entire base to raid. So that's why I will look at where all the 6 gold mines are located. Even for this Town Hall 7, there are also 6 gold mines. So going ahead to just deploy my troops at the bottom, focusing on the gold mines with just a V-shaped manner. Not really going to bother too much about the rest of the whole entire base, because I'm pretty sure I will be able to get the 1 star just by focusing at the bottom. Even if I don't get the 1 star, just losing the attack is not really a big problem, because I will be able to snipe a bit of Town Hall to get my way up again. So I managed to get the 1 star, 56%. Going back to my base, my wizard tower has finished its construction. So my third level 1 wizard tower has just completed its upgrade, so going ahead to remove an obstacle and getting 1 gem from the bush. And then now going ahead to upgrade the walls with the 1.5 million gold that I have in my capacity. And then just going ahead to upgrade some more walls as I was trying to get my air defense up. Another new air defense, so I was trying to save up to like 22,500 gold. So I didn't want to spend all my gold, and of course to have a little bit of gold left to do some searches. So it's not been easy to find a lot of raids, a lot of high loot raids right now. So now you can see I spent like roughly 15,000 gold, which was like roughly 30 searches to find this base. So it's not easy to find, especially with such a low trophy count. So I need to push my way up a little, but not to worry, I'll definitely push my way up soon. Maybe hitting to 1,006 or 1,007 to farm my way over there, because Silver League isn't too good for Tower 8 in my opinion. So now just going ahead to upgrade more walls once my air defense have completed its upgrade. And then just going ahead to upgrade my next stuff, which is the army camp, getting 8 in one day time. So 5 more housing spaces will definitely do good to me. So going ahead to do more raids, getting more gold from this base, this Tower 8. So Tower 8 versus Tower 8, the loot penalty will be no loot penalty, which I will be able to get 100% loot from this base. But once I reach the Tower 9, I will see this guy only 90% loot available. Not too really worrying for me, but definitely it's going to be more worrying if I'm a Tower 10. If I see this guy, I'll see like half the amount that I'm seeing, which is going to be just 100 over 1000 loot. So it's not going to be good for me. So now just ending the raid with 234,000 gold that I've gotten. So for those of you who have been wondering where I went to, I actually went to Mega Asia. Mega Asia is another part of a clan with a Mega Empire Asia. It's a family alliance. So I went there to farm and also talk to some of the guys over there to have a chat. So what happened was I actually met up with some of the Mega Asia people. I met up with them as in real life to have dinner with them, and then we had a chat. And then I did ask the co-leader, who's Jojo. I asked him whether I was able to bring my account over there to farm. So actually Jojo and I, we knew each other for very long, ever since we were together in Empire X, which was like many months ago. In fact, I was quite close with him to the extent whereby I meet him not very often, but I do chit chat with him on a group chat. So definitely he knows me relatively okay. So maybe not okay for him, but well enough. So he actually allowed me to join the clan, that's one. And of course bring some accounts over to help out with the donations, because this account definitely not going to donate level 4 archers to them. They won't be pleased with that. I won't be pleased to donate a level 4 archers to them. So bringing a spare account over there to donate some wizards and witches over there will definitely help them, and also be able to communicate and also mingle with other alliance mates. So it's good to know more people other than the people in SG Gladiators and also in Mega Empire Asia. So I might be spending 2 weeks as in one season over here in Mega Asia, and then maybe proceeding on to other Mega family clans such as a Mega Town or a Mega Farm or Mega Town 2. So I might progress my way as to go around to mingle around with other people to just get to know the family a little better. So just going ahead with this raid, over 300,000 gold I have stolen. So that particular raid, it was quite funny. Eventually, actually all these raids were all done when I was at a meetup. So what happened was Jojo, he was like complaining to me saying, "Hey, it's very hard to farm and he can't find any loot." He was like having a hard time finding loot because he's a Tower 10, that's one. And of course, he was farming at 2,800 over trophies. He couldn't find a loot as much as I, because I'm a Tower 8. So whenever I find this loot, then I will just show to him, say, "Hey, I found a loot." So then after he'll say, "Hey, pass to me. He wants to help me to raid. I say, "No, I do not allow him to raid for me, because I know his skill of raiding ain't that good." Not trying to down talk him, but yeah, it's true, because he uses 240 archers to farm, and he doesn't know how to use barbarian archers to farm. So I didn't have enough trust for him to actually farm for me, and I was kind of rushing my goal. So and some of the time at that point of time we were searching was quite bad for the loot to actually come to us. So I was trying really hard to actually farm my goal, and I couldn't even farm up to the max capacity. I only farmed like up to 2.4 million gold, as you can see. So yeah, I'm in Mega Empire Asia, so not to worry, I'll still be there for the next 2 weeks. I will update you guys once I move to another clan. And I don't think I'll be going to any of your clans if you guys are wondering whether I might able to go to your clans to actually farm over there or talk to you guys. But I don't think I'll be doing that because it'll be too hectic and also too effort taking, because a lot of people will be asking me to go over to their clan to actually farm over there, this and that, and then a lot of people will be chatting me. But I don't usually chat in the clan because I'll be too busy handling other accounts and also doing other stuff. So yeah, I've been upgrading my wards a lot, and then now as you can see my profile, I've gotten 53 attack wands for the start of the new season. So yeah, it's the start of the new season, it's like roughly half the day and I got like 53 wins already. So hopefully be able to get more wins and also progress my way even more, maybe getting my gold grab to like a 3 million, not 3 million but 300 million, sorry. So 300 million gold grab, maybe by before the end of the season, hopefully be able to do it too. So yeah, that's it for this update for this particular episode. Hope you guys have enjoyed it as much as I have. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.